Hello guys, it's Shin Game Plays. I'm Fabio Pisco, and welcome to my channel.
Don't let your dreams be dreams.
So as for today's video, you might remember that I actually have lots of overclocking videos for the AMD cards, for example the RX 570, 580, 6600, 6600 XT, lots of AMD cards. But today we actually have an overclocking guide for the RTX 3060, in this case from the Inno 3D. Not that it does matter, because it doesn't. Now, two important things before starting the overclocking, which is, first one, it doesn't matter the brand of your GPU. This is an overclocking guide for the RTX 3060. It doesn't matter if it is from Asus, from ASRock, from EVGA, MSI, from Nvidia, from Inno 3D Palette. It just doesn't matter, okay? As long as it is an RTX 3060, you're good to go. The second one is, take in consideration that all GPUs are different. You can get, for example, 30 or 40 RTX 3060 cards, and all of them will have different binning. So all of them will overclock differently. Some will overclock over the average, others will be on average, most of them, that's why it's average, and some of them will be below average. So most of them will overclock like this video, some others can overclock more, and others can overclock less, okay? So this video is just a guide. Your card may overclock more or may overclock less than mine, okay? All cards are different. Now let's go to the overclocking part right after the sponsor of today's video. For today's sponsor we have GVG Mall, where you can acquire your Windows 10 Home Serial Key for only $16. And using my SKAG discount code will get you 20% off, making it only $11. After the payment, you'll receive the key in your account, and after getting it, you simply need to introduce it in your Windows settings, and BAM! You have an activated system. Now, this video will be actually pretty short because this is just overclocking and not undervolting, okay? It is just an overclocking tutorial, unlike, for example, my Radeon ones where I overclock and undervolt, so it is a bit harder to get to the sweet spots, and it will definitely be harder than this process we're doing here, okay? Usually I use the Radeon settings because we actually have an overclocking kit inside the Radeon drivers, okay? Thing that we don't have on the Nvidia side, which I think it's a miss because we have to install other software to actually have it overclocked. But in this case, well, it is what it is, and it won't just won't be a problem, okay? Now, for that, just go to your browser and write MSI Afterburner. We're gonna use it because MSI Afterburner is one of the most used, if not the most used, kits to overclock and have overlays in game, okay? Go here, MSI Afterburner, and download it. You can actually download it to your desktop, for example, save. Now, all you have to do is open with WinRAR or 7-zip, extract it to your desktop, for example, then just run it, click two times, run it, install it, and if it actually asks you to do a reboot, just reboot your computer, okay? Simple as it can be. Now, after installing, you'll actually have an icon for the MSI Afterburner on your system, on your desktop, or you can just go here and press MSI Afterburner and it will appear here on the search bar. Open it. Now, as soon as you open MSI Afterburner, this is what you'll see. You'll basically have the GPU frequency, the memory frequency, and the voltage and the temperature, okay? Then you have three menus below. You have the voltage menu, the clock menu, and the fan menu. On the fan one, you actually have the power limit, which is 100%, and you have the temperature limit, which is set to 83 degrees, and you actually don't need to change this because these cards are pretty cool. I hardly manage to go over 70 degrees in most games, so I don't think you'll be actually seeing temperatures over 75 degrees on this card, so the temperature limit stock, which is 83 degrees, will be completely fine. Fan speed the same and power limit the same. As for the voltage, like I told you, this is not an undervolting tutorial, so we're not going to undervolt, although we can't. So we can only go over and not below. Now, take in consideration that raising the voltage may damage your GPU to a certain extent because you're raising the voltage over the stock one. It may cause, for example, degrading, or it may cause like permanent damage. So you can actually break your GPU by raising the voltage too much. It doesn't mean that, for example, if you raise the voltage 10%, that you will damage your GPU. But in some scenarios, depending on the GPU, you may damage it by raising the voltage, by putting the offset on the voltage. Okay, so let's stay with stock voltage because that's all you need so far. So let's go to the clocks. Now, the clocks are very easy. You have the core clock, which is your GPU clock, and you have the memory clock, which is your VRAM clock. So basically those 12 gigabytes of GDDR6 that you see in the box and that you see in Windows, this is it, memory clock. You're overclocking those 12 gigabytes of GDDR6. Okay, so let's start with the core clock. As for the core clock, I advise you to go in 50 megahertz increments. So start with 50 megahertz and then apply. Bam! Test a heavy game without any frame limiters, like for example Control, God of War, some really heavy game that pushes your GPU to 100% usage. Try it for, let's say, at least like half an hour, and if it is all working fine, then go and try 100 MHz. Apply once again and play for another half an hour. If it doesn't crash, if the game doesn't quit, then it is stable. Go once again to 150 MHz and bam. If it is stable once again, go to 200. And if it is stable once again, go to 250 and so on, till you reach your maximum core overclock. In my case, it is 150 MHz because over that some games will crash. Some others, some lighter ones won't, but the heavier ones will crash at plus 200, and that's why I keep it at 150 to be actually stable. Now, as for the memory clock, do the same, start with 50 MHz increments, although for the first one you can start already with 150, so start with 150 MHz, test once again half an hour, if it is stable go to 200. Apply, once again, if it is stable, go to 250, if it is stable, 300, and so on. In my case, it is stable up to 500 or 550, but to be on the stabler part, on the most stable part, I keep it at 500. In some scenarios, you may be able to push it to 550, 600, or even 700, depending on your GPU's binning. And the same goes for the core clock. So keep raising it and testing it till you find your sweet spot or till you find your maximum overclock ability, okay? Because like I told you before, all cards are different and your card may overclock more than this or may overclock less than this. But overall, I think this will be kind of a sweet spot in terms of overclocking with plus 150 and plus 500 MHz in the VRAM, okay? Basically, that's it. It is as simple as it can be. All you need to do, download MS Afterburner and do these steps and you have your GPU overclocked. For you to see the difference in between stock and overclocked results, I actually have two or three games in the end of this video, like 1 minute after this precise moment, where I will be showing you side by side the difference in between stock and overclock values for you to see in terms of actual FPS numbers, okay? Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and share this video because that really helps a lot. And well, see you in the next one, which will be the RX 6600 versus 6600 XT versus this RTX 3060. Both stock, overclocked, and with resizable bar and smart access memory results, which are very important. Thanks a lot and see you in the next video.
hole hidden behind that poster that leads to the real world. We all feel safe in that room. But sometimes something crawls out from behind the poster. And the ones that see it happen freak out and try to forget what they saw. I'm here. Why did you bring me here?
Hello?